This day in history, May 15th, 1982, the song Ebony and Ivory tops the music chart, and here's the story. Ebony and Ivory is a song written and performed by Paul McCartney and Stevie Wonder, one of my favorite tunes. The song was released March 29th, 1982, as a part of McCartney's Tug of War album. The song became a huge commercial success, I remember it from my childhood, reaching the top of the music charts in many countries, including the United States, England, Canada, Australia, and New Zealand. The song was written as a commentary on racial harmony and the need for people to work together, with the ebony, of course, representing black people, and the ivory representing white people. The song was well received by critics and has been praised for its message of unity and inclusion. The music video for Ebony and Ivory features McCartney and Wonder playing keyboards together and singing in front of a white background with images of black and white hands intermingling. Ebony and Ivory remains one of the most popular and recognizable songs from the early 80s and continues to be played on the radio stations and pop culture references to this day. Again, one of my favorite songs. I should leave you the YouTube link in the comments. And if you don't know this song, you have to listen. It's a fantastic tune. Thanks for stopping in to the Top B, History with Mr. B, and I'll see you folks soon. May 16th, 1980, Magic Johnson wins the NBA title as a rookie. Here's the story. Magic Johnson, highly touted basketball prospect. He came out of Michigan State University, and he was selected as the first overall pick by the Los Angeles Lakers in 1979. Johnson quickly made an impact in his rookie season, earning a starting spot and helping lead the Lakers to a 60-22 regular season record. In the NBA Finals against the Philadelphia 76ers, Johnson famously stepped in to play for an injured Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in Game 6, and he delivered one of the greatest performances in NBA history. Magic Johnson scored on that night 42 points. He grabbed 15 rebounds. He dished out 7 assists in the game, leading the Lakers to a 123-107 victory and securing the NBA championship. Johnson was named the NBA Finals MVP for his outstanding performance and becoming the first rookie in NBA history to earn that honor. Johnson's incredible rookie season helped establish him as one of the greatest basketball players of all time, and he went on to win 4 more NBA titles with the Lakers over the course of his storied career. Johnson retired from the NBA in 1991 after announcing he had contracted HIV, the virus that causes AIDS. He has since become an advocate for HIV/AIDS awareness and research and has reduced to work the stigma surrounding the disease. Johnson has also been successful, mega successful in business, and he's the owner of Magic Johnson Enterprises, a conglomerate that holds real estate holdings, movie theaters, Burger Kings. I mean, he owns everything. In addition to his basketball and business achievements, Johnson is well known for his philanthropic work and has been recognized with numerous awards for his contributions to society. So today's for you, Magic Johnson. It's History with Mr. B. As always, I appreciate you tuning in, and I'll see you folks tomorrow. This day in history, it's History with Mr. B. Today we look at the Supreme Court and their landmark decision, May 17th, 1954, Brown versus the Board of Education. Now, if you've never heard, it was a landmark case for the United States. Brown versus the Board of Education was when the Supreme Court ruled that a segregated or separated public schools were unconstitutional. The case was brought about by an African-American parent in Topeka, Kansas, who argued that the separate but equal doctrine established in 1896 in the court case Plessy versus Ferguson was inherently unequal and violated the 14th Amendment's Equal Protection Clause. The lead in this case was Oliver Brown, a father whose daughter was denied admission to a white school near their home. The case was heard by the Supreme Court in 1952, and the court initially decided to rehear the case in 1953, during which time the arguments were expanded to include all public schools in the United States. On May 17, 1954, the Supreme Court issued its unanimous decision in the case, ruling that segregation in public schools was unconstitutional, ordering that desegregation proceed with all deliberate speed. The decision in Brown versus the Board was a major milestone in the civil rights movement, and it paved way for desegregation in schools and other public institutions. Despite the ruling, desegregation efforts were met with resistance in many parts of the country, especially the South, and it took years of legal battles, protests, and activism to fully implement the principles laid out in that decision. The case has been widely celebrated as a landmark victory for civil rights and a pivotal movement in American history. So today we remember Brown versus the Board of Education. It's History with Mr. B. I will see you folks soon. Thanks for stopping in as always. Welcome back. It's History with Mr. B. And today is an explosive episode. May 18th, 1980, Mount Saint Helens, a volcano in the state of Washington in the United States, without warning erupts. The eruption was the deadliest and most destructive volcanic event in the history of the United States. The eruption was triggered by a 5.1 magnitude earthquake, which caused the north face of the mountain to just completely collapse. This led to a massive landslide and the release of pent-up gas and magma, which resulted in a powerful explosion that sent ash, rock, and gas 80,000 feet into the air. The eruption killed 57 people, including a geologist who was studying the volcano, and caused extensive damages to homes, businesses, and infrastructure. The ash cloud from the eruption also caused significant disruption to air travel and agriculture in the region. The eruption of Mount St. Helens was a wake-up call for the scientific community and the public about a potential dangers of volcanic activity, and it led to the increased monitoring and researching of volcanoes around the world. Today, the area around Mount St. Helens is a popular tourist trap and a site for ongoing research and education about volcanoes and their impact on the environment and human communities. Now, I'll see you folks next time. Thanks for always tuning in to History with Mr. B. I'm your top B, Mr. B. Welcome back to History with Mr. B. And today, I will tell you about an iconic human being that you may have never heard of. Here's the story. May 19th, 1935, T.E. Lawrence, also known as Lawrence of Arabia, dies in a motorcycle accident in England. Once again, I only celebrate the positive and the life, not the death, so here we go. Lawrence of Arabia was a British soldier, an archaeologist, and a writer, best known for his role in the Arab Revolt during World War I, depicted in his memoir, Seven Pillars of Wisdom. Lawrence was a completely complex and controversial figure, admired by many for his leadership and strategic abilities, but also criticized sometimes for his ruthless tactics and ambiguous relationship with the British government. He played a key role in rallying Arab forces against the Ottoman Empire. We just learned about that in my class in World War I, and his efforts were instrumental in the eventual establishment of the independent Arab states in the region. After the war, Lawrence struggled to reconcile his experiences with the political realities of the post-war world. He returned to Britain and served in various roles in government and the military, but he remained disillusioned with the British establishment and continued to advocate for Arab independence. Lawrence's death was a shock to many, and it sparked widespread mourning and speculation about what may he have accomplished if he had lived longer. He remains an iconic figure in popular culture, and his legacy continues to be debated, and interpreted to this day. Once again, that's History with Mr. B. That's Lawrence of Arabia. I will see you folks next week. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate all of you. Thank you. Oh.